It's another beautiful day, so why not take a beautiful British Grand Tourer for a spin? We've got the 2021 Jaguar F-Type R. Let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, this 2021 Jaguar F-Type R is something else. There's really not much like it. This is a quintessential Grand Tourer. It's not pretending to be a sports car. It's not pretending to be a supercar. It is clearly and unabashedly a Grand Tourer. Now, the recipe has not changed much, and it is still very elegant. It is very refined and very distinctive. This thing gets so much attention, almost as much attention as a supercar, believe it or not. This F-Type defines Grand Tourer. Big engine under the long bonnet, two seats, a little bit of cargo room, short deck. This just is the quintessential GT. Under that bonnet is a 5-liter supercharged V8 making 575 horsepower at 6,500 RPM and 516 pounds of torque from 3,500 to 5,000 RPM. The transmission is that wonderful 8-speed automatic, and there is an E-diff in the back with brake-based torque vectoring. Oh yes. Suspension is double wishbones all around, adaptive dampers. There are two piston calipers up front, single piston in the rear, massive 15-inch rotors at the front and 14.8 rotors in the rear. Steering is electrically assisted, of course. Wheels and tires are 20s with 265 wide tires at the front and 305s at the rear. These are Pirellis and they've got a lot of stick. Like I said, it is a proper GT, so there are only two seats, but that leaves lots of cargo capacity under the hatch, which is fantastic if you're gonna take this on a road trip. Curb weight of this new F-Type is 3,640 pounds, which is lighter than I anticipated. It's that time in the episode for how to spec your Jaguar F-Type. Base price in the United States is $103,200. In Canada, it's $119,000. What you're looking at is the Blue Fire Blue paint with an ebony interior and the 20-inch 5-split spoke rims. This one is fitted with important things like the fixed panoramic roof, the climate pack, the wheels, of course. Much of the suede cloth throughout the interior is optional, and the top Meridian sound system. As tested, that puts us at $112,040 in the US or $128,090 in Canada. Now, how do you spec yours? I do like this specification. Not a fan of the blue, that is simply a personal choice, but I do like the wheels. I do like this interior, and the sound system is wonderful. I think it's fairly easy to spec your Jaguar F-Type, but this and maybe black would be a little more sinister and suit that attitude of this Jaguar F-Type, that's for sure. Because this is a GT, I'm sitting in a more relaxed seating position than I normally do, and it is so comfortable here. I love these seats. They just hug you, and they're just perfect for the mission here in a Grand Tourer. It's very, very comfortable, but I've got myself a little bit more reclined and a little bit more pushed back from the steering wheel and the pedals than I normally do. This kind of driving experience deserves this kind of seating position. No, you don't really need to be on top of the steering wheel and attacking this car. No, this is something you drive with a little more relaxation in mind. It is very spacious in the cabin. Storage is limited here. There's lots of storage in the back, as I mentioned. However, this cabin is enhanced by the glass roof. It is very spacious and airy and open in here. And while it's relatively quiet, and sure, you can dial up the sound system and blast your favorite music, but it is a wonderful driving experience, and the interior is very pretty. All the leather throughout the cabin and this suede is just gorgeous in here. ergonomics are very much Jaguar. Not much has changed. The shifter is very much the same, and all of the switchgear seems to be very familiar as well. It's a very straightforward, if distinctive, set of ergonomics, but it works very, very well in here, and it adds to the charm of the cabin, that's for sure. The infotainment system seems to be Jaguar's latest, works just fine. Rest assured, there is still no AM radio. That's something that Jaguar Land Rover loves to do. There is no AM radio if that's your jam, but it does have Apple CarPlay, so I can listen to my music on my phone, use Waze, works great. And this big screen is highly visible, even in some direct sunlight. I'm very impressed with that. The digital cluster here as well is brilliant. Right now, I've got my map showing up on the right, in addition to the tach dead center. And then, of course, the speedometer. Who really cares about the speed limit when you're driving something as pretty as this? While we're talking about tech, I do have to mention it does have lane keep assist, but there is no adaptive cruise, which might be a consideration for some buyers. Now, in terms of acceleration, that's probably the best part of the experience. Not only does it go, but it sounds great as well. 0 to 60 is apparently 3.5 seconds. That is just remarkable for something like this. I mean, that's near supercar levels of acceleration, and top speed is 180 plus, I think. I mean, this thing can be very, very fast as well. I'm curious what the aerodynamics are like at high speeds, but that's another consideration for another day. But that motor is just brilliant. Lots of power, way up high in the rev range, and lots of torque, a very broad torque curve as well. And it works great with the 8-speed automatic. The eDIFF has no trouble putting power down as well, and it helps that there are some pretty big, meaty Pirellis under here. This drivetrain really gives the F-Type R the character of a British hot rod. It's, you know, it's got a whole lot of attitude and a lot of grunt. It is remarkable at how quick it is and then how loud it is. Sure, you want to drive around sometimes more relaxed, sedate fashion, but every once in a while, you know, you change the drive mode or hit the exhaust button, things open up, and then it's wonderful. It just sounds fantastic. And there's really nothing like the sound of this 5-liter supercharged V8 in this F-Type. It's just brilliant. And I love getting the throttle and making noise with it. Even though this is not a hardcore sports car, it's not a hardcore supercar, it has no trouble putting down power. Here, let's hustle into this corner, down a bunch of gears, turn in, get back onto the throttle. It just is fantastic. Sure, the car moves around a little bit because I'm asking it to put down a lot of power, but the chassis communicates with you as well. But that eDIFF and the brake-based torque vectoring works very, very well here. Got tremendous confidence in the corners with this F-Type. The wonderful thing about this F-Type is that the chassis really communicates with you. You can feel what's going on. If you think of this as a cat or a Jaguar, as some of my friends might say, what Jaguar's done is they've let the suspension work so that each tire can really do its thing. Body and wheel motion is excellent, but they've allowed the suspension to really work here. So yes, you've got a bit of body roll and that's just fine, but each corner works. So over bumps and through road imperfections, the suspension just soaks all of that up, making sure that the tire is in contact with the road. And yet it's controlling body motion exceptionally well as well. And I think that's due to the adaptive dampers. They just do a fine job here. And in terms of outright grip, there's no problem at all. And what I love about the F-Type is how it communicates. I can feel what's going on at each contact patch, which is a rarity these days. It is a pleasure to drive in that regard. And then with the relatively short wheelbase and all of that power, you can point it on the throttle. You can drive this car on the throttle. It is a breath of fresh air in terms of Grand Tours. It is a pleasure to drive, and I love it. Steering is direct and precise, and there's still a little bit more feedback coming through
the steering wheel than I anticipated. Yes, the chassis feel is excellent, but there's a decent amount of feel that comes through the steering wheel as well. And brake feel is excellent as well. I'm gonna dive into this corner here, get on the big brakes, no problem at all. You've got millimeter control with that brake pedal. It's another rarity these days. It's, you know, this is a Grand Tourer. It's not a sports car yet. It's got those sports car quality inputs. I'm really impressed with it. As a package, there's nothing quite like this. Sure, you may think there are some close competitors, but there's nothing like this. It's very British in terms of aesthetic. It's very British in terms of attitude. It is a wonderfully well-rounded Grand Tourer, and that motor and that exhaust sound just is icing on the cake of this GT. My verdict, well, at this point in the episode, we do talk about fuel consumption, and not that it matters, averaging 16 or 17 miles per gallon, and that's just fine. And the reason that is, this is such a pleasure to drive. It's an elegant package. It rides exceptionally well. It handles exceptionally well. And when you get into the throttle and that exhaust starts to bellow, well, this has a whole pile of attitude. It becomes this British hot rod. There's really nothing like it, and a lot of manufacturers just don't make anything like this anymore, and I'm sure glad that Jaguar still does. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2021 Jaguar F-Type R. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube. You know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this, especially on Reddit, because they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers over there. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even gorgeous British Grand Tourers.